Well, hey, this is a wild discovery. So this question from Lasma: I want to group dates in a pivot, but there's blank cells in the date column. Why can't I group dates? Excel doesn't recognize the data as a date. All right, common problem. Been around this a lot, but I'm shocked and amazed that someone at Microsoft has fixed this. So see this date column? I'm in Microsoft 365 now, in the course of the beta channel. Insert pivot table. Okay. Take dates, drag them to the rows area. Take revenue, drag it to the values area. And normally, in the past, I wouldn't be able to group this because of that blank cell, but it's amazing. The group field is showing that it's a date, and I can group it up to months and years. And they do this thing where all of the blank cells are showing up as less than August 6, 2022, with a date of blank, which is crazy. When did this get fixed? I have no idea when this got fixed. All right, but obviously, for Lasma, she's having the same problem that in the old days, so she's not on Microsoft 365. So my two suggestions. Suggestion number one is, first off, take everything in the date field and go to all of the blank cells. All right, so I'm going to choose all of the cells like this. I'm holding down the shift key while I press page down, and then F5 to open go to, click special, choose blanks, which should get me all the blanks, and then one of two dates, either January 1st of 1900 or 12/31 of, let's say, 2199, just to be insanely far in the future. Control enter, that'll fill all of that data in, and then we can do insert pivot table. Okay, dates down the left hand side, revenue, and now you should successfully be able to group these dates by months and years, and you just have this 2199, you know, thing. Like, why don't those have dates? I don't know why they don't have dates, but if you don't want them in here, just, you know, open this and take out any dates in 2199, click OK, right, and there you kind of have the solution. Or think about what the date grouping is doing. It's taking this date and it's converting it in memory to a year and a month. So let's just do that right here in the original data set. So the equal year function there, copy that down to all of our date cells. And then for everything else, I'll just put NA or whatever you want to do. I don't care. Whatever makes sense to you. And then for the month, check this out. Instead of the equal month, which will give me a month number, like here, this would give me a month number of 8. Instead of that, I'm going to use equal text of the date, comma, MMMM inside of quotes. Four M's will spell out the month, August. Three M's will just give you AUG. See, so that's going to actually give me the month name there. That'll be a little bit better than how Excel creates these. And then for everything here, we'll put NA all of the way down. Good. Now, insert, pivot table. Okay. We're not going to use the date field this time. Instead, we'll use the years and the month field and then the revenue field like that. And to get rid of the things without dates, just open this year up and unselect NA. And there you go. All right. Shout out to Debra Dogleash at Contextures. I went to Debra. I said, Debra, am I misremembering this? So this used to be broken, and she confirms that it is. But then Debra pointed out to be careful here. Now, Lasma is saying that she has blank rows, which implies completely blank rows. But Debra pointed out if it's a mix of dates and text like this, then it's not going to allow grouping. Here on the pivot table analyze tab, grouping is going to be grayed out. So, you know, that's not going to work. Or, you know, the other one is if when they say I have a blank cell, I'm assuming that there was never data there, or they simply pressed delete, right? But unfortunately, I've been burned enough to know that some people say a blank cell means that they pressed a space bar and enter, or even worse, space, 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 enter. Why would you do that? So something like that with spaces instead of blank cells, insert, pivot table, okay, date, and revenue is going to create something that we cannot group, right? So if the group field is still grayed out and you're on Microsoft 365, it's possible that what's really there is a space or space, 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 or just simply text. Thanks to Debra for pointing that out. So fascinating that Excel is now dealing with this and allowing me to group dates when there's a few blank cells in the middle. crazy that that's working now. Have no idea when that got added. Second solution is fill all of the blank empty date cells with a ridiculous date, December 31st of 2199, or use the year function like that and the text function to convert a year, and in order to create a year and month field, and then base the pivot table on that. Well, I want to thank Lasma for that great question, and I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.